Let's look at the Surah Al-Fatiha. We all know Surah Al-Fatiha to read, and we got the meanings of what Surah Al-Fatiha. Definitely 5 times a prayer. We pray, and 5 times we're praying 17 rak'ah. In every rak'ah we're reciting Surah Al-Fatiha. Right? So that is the beginning of the Quran, and Surah Al-Nas is the end. I'm just making some connections, and we're going to get to the deep meanings, inshallah, very soon. So what is Surah Al-Fatiha mean? Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. In the name of Allah, most gracious, most beneficent. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Praise be to Allah, the Lord of the worlds. Ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, the merciful, the most merciful, and the most beneficent. Maliki Yawmiddin, He is the Lord of the Day of Judgment, the Day of Resurrection. إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين. Oh Allah, You only we worship, and from You only we seek help. إهدنا الصراط المستقيم. So show us the straight path. Show us the straight way. صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم. The path of those whom You have bestowed Your mercy upon them. The path of those whom You have favored them. غير المغضوب عليهم. Not the path of those who got your wrath, who got anger from you, you know, who you've been unhappy with. You don't want their path, Allah. وَلَضَّالِّينَ, and not the path of those who went astray, not through the straight path, who gone deviated. We don't want their path. So show us the path of those who You have favored. صِرَاطَ الَّذِينَ أَنْعَمْتَ عَلَيْهِمْ. So the entire surah, the commentators of Quran mention Surah Al-Fatiha. The first surah of Quran is also named Surah Ta'lim Al-Mas'ala. This is teaching you how to ask Allah. Surah Al-Fatiha is a surah that would teach you how you would ask Allah. How do you ask Allah? We have a lot many things to ask from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for the things that we have concerns about this world, and the things that concerning the world after. It is teaching you what to ask. Alright, so what did we ask Allah in Surah Al-Nas, Surah Al-Fatiha? What was the question? One only question. There's only one question we ask in Surah Al-Fatiha. يَهْدِنَا الصِّرَاطَ الْمُسْتَقِيمِ. Oh Allah, guide us to the straight path. Who is calling this? Who is reading this surah? Muslims, yeah? Because Muslims recite this surah. Can be non-Muslims who want to learn what is in Quran, of course. But Muslims who pray 5 times a day and reciting Surah Al-Fatiha 17 times in their daily life, every day, 17 times. You asking Allah, guide us to the straight path. Guide us to the straight path. So what path have you been to? What the path you are now? You are in the straight path, of course. But you're asking Allah, I don't want to be a normal Muslim. Like a low-grade Muslim. No, I want to be a Muslim who is upgraded. A Muslim who is in the highest ranks with you. صِرَاطَ الَّذِينَ أَنْعَمْتَ عَلَيْهِمْ. The path of those whom You have favored. Who are they? Quran explains in another ayah, Bismillahi أولئك مع الذين أنعم الله عليهم من النبيين والصديقين والشهداء والصالحين. Definitely, those people will be in heaven with those who Allah has favored upon them, and these people are none but the prophets of Allah, the messengers of Allah. صراط الذين أولئك مع الذين أنعم الله عليهم من النبيين. Who are those who have been favored by Allah? Allah's messengers. من النبي والصديقين, and the righteous people. والشهداء, and the martyrs who died, who sacrificed for the sake of Allah, for the sake of Allah's religion, those who martyred in the way of Allah. والصالحين, شهداء والصالحين, and all the people who do good deeds. So we want to be in their path. So what have you been asking from the beginning of the surah? Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. In the name of Allah, praise be to Allah. Ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, He is the most merciful, He is the most beneficent. Maliki Yawmiddin, He is the Lord of the Day of Resurrection. We didn't ask Allah anything. These are simply praising Allah, glorifying Allah. We haven't put what we're going to ask Him. We didn't ask Allah yet. And yet we say, إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ وَإِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينَ. Oh Allah, Thy only be worship and from thou only be seek help. In a hadith it came, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentions that when a person recited this verse from Surah Fatiha, Allah would say as an answer, لِعَبْدِي مَا سَأَلْ أَضَّمَنِي عَبْدِي وَلِعَبْدِي مَا سَأَلْ My slave has praised me and I'm going to give whatever my slave is going to ask me. Then we're going to ask him, اِهْدِنَا السِّرَاطَ الْمُسْتَقِيمِ Oh Allah, guide us to the straight path. صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم, the path of those whom you have favored, غير المغضوب عليهم, nor the path of those who got your anger, and not of those who went astray. There's only one Christian, and lot of praisings of Allah. Come to the Surah An-Nas. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. قل أعوذ برب الناس ملك الناس إله الناس. I seek refuge in Allah, the Lord of the people. I seek refuge in Allah, the King of the people. In Allah, the God of the people. From what are you seeking refuge? Min شَدْرِ الْوَسْوَاسِ الْخَنَّاسِ From the whispering of the devil. From the whisperings of shaitan. Al-Khannas, Khannas in Arabic, that means who would withdraw very easily. And that means whenever you remember Allah, shaitan will withdraw. Shaitan will flee. He will flee away the moment you remember of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The time you mention Allah's name, shaitan will run away. But shaitan has a dominant power on your heart. So Allah is asking, you ask for Allah guidance in Surah Al-Fatiha, اِهْدِنَا السِّرَاطَ الْمُسْتَقِيمِ Allah gave you guidance. You read the whole Quran. Are you reaching to the end? Now you seek refuge in Allah, that shaitan may not lead you astray. Ask Allah protection. Our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, before the revelation of this surah, Surah Al-Falaq and Surah Al-Nas, the two surahs that are the second last surah, which is Surah Qul A'udhu Bi Rabbil Falaq, and the last surah Qul A'udhu Bi Rabbin Nas, these two surahs are known as Al-Mu'abbidatan. Al-Mu'abbidatan in Arabic, that means the surahs by which you ask Allah refuge, you seek refuge from Allah. These two surahs are prayers. Quran has begun with prayer in Surah Al-Fatiha and is ending with prayer. Subhanallah. There is a difference. قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ الْفَلَقِ and قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ النَّاسِ The two surahs were revealed at the same time. There had been some reasons for the revelation of Quran. You know, for so many verses and even for some surahs that were revealed, there would be some reasons behind. But the reason for these two surahs was only one thing that happened in the life of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, which Imam Bukhari in his book, in Kitab al-Tib, in the book of medicine, he has mentioned the hadith of some bewitchment that happened to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We will explain about it inshallah later. قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ الْفَلَقِ أَنْ قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ النَّاسِ Imam Muslim, the great compiler of the hadith, Imam Muslim rahimahullah, in his famous book Sahih Muslim, he has referred to the hadith that says, Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, before the revelation of the surah قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ الْفَلَقِ أَنْ قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ النَّاسِ he would ask Allah, he used to pray to Allah protection from the evil eyes of man and jinn kind, from both. We know, in our tradition, evil eye, which is called Ayn in Arabic, it also means eye and also means evil eye. كان يتعبد من أعين الجن ومن أعين الإنس وأعين الجن. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم used to seek protection from Allah from the evil eyes of men and that of jinn, all the jinn kind. Like the mankind and the jinn kind. But when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed these two surahs, قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ الْفَلَقِ and قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ النَّاسِ He abandoned everything. تَرَكَ مَا سِوَاهُمَا Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam abandoned everything and he held only these two surahs in hand and he used to use them every time and repeatedly he used to recite these surahs to seek protection. Of course we all are in need of Allah. Allah is al-ghaniyyu al-hamid. Allah is the self-eternal and Allah doesn't need anyone to help him, but we all need Allah. We're going to learn about it inshallah in قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدْ اللَّهُ الصَّمَدْ اللَّهُ الصَّمَدْ Allah is a self-eternal. Everybody is in need of Allah and Allah is in need of none. everyone is in need of Allah and Allah is in need of no one. Subhanallah. So ask Allah refuge. So everything that comes in our life, we should be praying to Allah. The more we pray to Allah, we're getting dearer and closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There is a poem which is in Arabic. It says, تَرَبِّنَ آدَمَ حِينَ يُسْأَلُ يَغْضَبُ وَتَرَى الْإِلَهَ لِسُؤْلِكَ يَتَعَجَّبُ. When you ask man about something, if you seek help, if you need some money, and you ask your fellow men, they don't appreciate that you ask help from humans, yeah? They don't appreciate it. Maybe for the first time, all right. You borrow some money and you're going to go to him second time. He's going to frown at you, yeah? And for the third time, he will close the door behind you. You know, he's not going to open the door for you. So man, humans, they don't like to be asked for help. But Allah would become unhappy if you don't ask him. That is the difference. وَتَرَى الْإِلَهَ لِسُؤْلِكَ يَتَعَجَّبُ. If you don't ask Allah, Allah will be getting unhappy with you. He won't be happy. So ask Allah. The more you ask, the more He's going to give to you. So how many of us are asking Allah? We do our prayers, right? We do our five times prayers. Do we raise our hands to Allah in complete humility? That Allah, I'm nothing in front of you, Allah. I'm nothing. I'm the weakest creature on the earth. Allah, I need your help. Help me. Quran, throughout the Quran, is started by prayer and ending with prayer and seeking protection in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We need Allah's protection. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam recommended that every Muslim, whenever the sunset happens, we should recite قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ الْفَلَقِ and قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ النَّاسِ at least once each. After the sunset, every time at night, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, عندما إذا اشتكى من جسده شيء, if Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam had any sickness in his body, any sickness, any disease, any pain that happened in his body, he would repeatedly read these two surahs, قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ الْفَلَقِ and قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ النَّاسِ. He would breathe it into his hands and he would wipe over his body. Ummuna Aisha Siddiqa radiallahu anha, she narrated this hadith. And when Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was in the disease in which he passed away, he wasn't able to read these two surahs. So Aisha radiallahu anha, who used to help him, who used to nurse Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and she thought it's a matter of pride for her to look after Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the last days of his life. She narrated Imam Bukhari in all of the Sahih hadith. They have reported this hadith that Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he used to recite these two surahs whenever he had any pain in his body. But he was suffering from pain and that time he couldn't recite these surahs. Then Aisha radiallahu anha says, I used to recite it for him, and rather than using